Okay, guys, what's up? It's your boy DJ coming at you again. Look where I am in Illinois, out in the middle of somewhere, not nowhere. But anyway, I'm in, I guess, riding to some little town called Farmington in Illinois. Just doing some adventure riding on my Technogaz bi-bike. That's right, Technogaz bi-bike. Having some fun. Doing some back road and riding in the rain. Not really a rainstorm, but it stopped raining now, but it was raining earlier. Riding in the rain, riding along some fishing ponds, which is a lot of gravel riding and stuff like that. Just choosing a road with a bunch of gravel on it sometimes, just seeing where I will end up at. Using my power port there, got my USB speaker there. It's really kind of cool. Also, this power port has a dual, you can plug up to two devices in there. But anyway, keep my phone in there. Having a good time on the Technogaz buy box. I think my rear light is still on. Right now, I'm doing a mileage test again to see how many miles I can get off a tank of gas. Why? Because I want to know exacts. So let me show you what I've done. Of course, you start off with a full tank of gas, and then what I did was they got these new gas cans out, and they're supposed to be like leak proof, I believe. And check it out, in my storage box. Yes, I am packing around in a gas can extra fuel. See, look, it doesn't even spill over or anything. Pretty kind of neat. New gas can they got out. Got it at Walmart for like $10, guys. $10 for that gas can. So I can drive the bi-bike until I'm completely out of fuel, out of fuel, and I can see exactly what my mileage is. So that's what I'm doing. The more I ride this thing, the more I like it. Of course, I'm liking it a lot better since I cut that back pressure pipe off my exhaust. Again, it was restricted for the European market, Slovenia. As you can see, I got some dirt on it, baby. This bi-bike will be getting knobbies sometime soon, but I figured I might as well burn these tires up. I paid for them, so I'm gonna wear them down. I don't like to waste money. I'm cheap. So I'm gonna run those tires bald before I change them, because once I go knobbies, I will never go back to straight tires again. So I'm gonna enjoy these tires while they're on there, but once they're bald, once they're bald, I will be putting knobbies on this bike. The bike is doing very well as usual. I have no complaints. Right now I'm at 50 miles of travel off of a tank of gas. I don't know how much further I'm gonna get, but I'm gonna drive it until it stops on me. And then, like I just showed you guys, I got a 1 gallon of gas in that little bottle. Again, guys, that bottle is, this is my second time doing an adventure ride with it. That gas tank is a gas can, bottle, whatever you want to call it, holds 1 gallon. It was only like $10 or $11 at Walmart, guys. So it's kind of nice when you have these vehicles and, you know, you got small tanks of gas. You can at least get one of those and have an extra gallon with you. Yeah. So I will be using that on all my bikes, my WR, my Grom, and my Honda Metropolitan also. And I got a Pooch Maxi moped that I'm working on, a project I'm working on there. So yeah, I saw that Blake put up some cool footage on him zipping around on the bi-bike, which is awesome. I can't do that. Just me holding my camera right now. Maybe in the future I will be doing some video of me riding it, probably, if somebody doesn't beat me to it. But Blake did a much better job than I could do. His bike was kicking butt, flying. I think he did some a serious upgrade to it. But anyway, I haven't got my stock exhaust. I mean, my aftermarket exhaust. I am going to be doing that. But yeah, I've been riding along the highway. This is really the back roads here, but not along the highway, but on the roads that you're able to go on slower vehicles, and with a 55 mile an hour speed limit. And I've just been doing 32, 33 miles an hour. But what I do is I just ride that white line, baby. You don't have a white line right here, but I'm getting, I've been riding a long time, so it's not a problem for me. I just ride along the line. I'm maybe a foot outside the white line. something like that. You know, I do have the right to be on the road, you know. I am a licensed vehicle. So, the cars just have to go around or whatever. But I don't stay in the middle lane regardless. Only time I stay in the middle of the lane is when I am in a 30-mile, 35-mile-an-hour zone. I'll stay in the lane then. So, hang on. My sister's calling me. But anyway, having a lot of fun with this bike. Also, guys, just want to reiterate how nice it is with the backpack. Now, what I did now is went ahead and perfect my backpack on the bike. Check this junk out. I got the straps on there, nice and secure. Hang on, my sister's trying to call me. I got the straps on there, nice and secure. I got like the waist or chest strap right there. So it is really secure, guys, on the bike. It doesn't inhibit me in any way. It doesn't interfere with the turn signal or nothing. So I'm really liking that a lot. Liking that a whole lot. What else? Yeah, that's about it. Just back here on the back. It's starting to get dark, by the way. I'm about to get out of here and continue my adventure. I wanted to do 100 miles. So we'll see what happens. I'm already at 50. So we'll see what happens, but I'll be putting this video up and hopefully part two, I'll tell you how many miles I got. So just wanted to let you know that this bike is still running well. I like it a lot. I just need to get it fully unrestricted when I get that pipe from Blake's shop or whatever else. I'm just going to get the one that Technigas makes for this bike specifically. So I look forward to doing that. And yeah, guys, just out here trying. I'm in Illinois. Trying to enjoy this weather before the snow comes, because it's probably going to be a terrible winter. So, all right, guys, just want to make a video letting you know that this bike is kicking butt, doing good. My torque is, I'm very impressed with the torque with this thing, too, since I cut that dummy pipe, whatever the thing was on that back pressure pipe, whatever. All right, guys, I'll let you go. Peace.